Welcome back to Warthin Weekly News. This week, some controversy started up, so hit that subscribe button. Let's get into it. So, back on December 19th, there was an update in the changelog
about
critical damage, assists, and all that good stuff. It seemed rather important, and I did point it out in my weekly War Thunder news video. Now that it's been a few weeks, people have gotten an idea of how it impacts the game, and it is not good. So before we get to the side effects, let's talk about what the changes are exactly. I'll first read them verbatim. Critical hits in air battles has been changed. All hits that affect flight performance of an aircraft now record as critical. One player may only deal one critical hit to an opponent. When a player's aircraft is destroyed, all players who dealt critical damage on an enemy receive an assist. So at face value, it seems rather straightforward. Get a critical hit, get an assist. And critical hits only count for the shots that damage the aircraft's flight performance. However, if you think about this bit more, there's quite a few things that you can hit that don't affect flight performance that are still count as damage. I think the Redditor Ophichiuses explained the faults of the new system best. In his comment, he states, actually, it says if you deal critical damage that affects flight performance, you get an assist. Landing gear hits, radiator hits, knocking out gunners, and setting fires does not count in that list. Additionally, this means that you no longer get assists for any damage short of a critical, no matter how recently the hit occurred or how severe the overall damage was. It's particularly bad in SB, where a brief burst of fire can be enough to cause a loss of lift on one wing. A subsequent accelerated stall and crash by your opponent, but not count as a crit and therefore give no credit. I personally have actually felt the effects of this, as I had a very good game in the P-51 just the other day where I got 4 kills, a 5th enemy I lit on fire, but an ally killed them, and I was not credited with an assist, because I guess lighting someone on fire doesn't affect flight performance. It will eventually, but in the immediate it does not. And I'm not the only one who's taken note. Gaijin has noticed as well, and they had to reduce the amount of assists you had to get for the winter event that is currently going on for aircraft. Now, Gaijin's action to fix this issue is kind of annoying me, because it's pretty big. They even had to change the winter event, as I just said, yet there has been no action to fix it. The changelog is completely empty this week, but they did make an acknowledgement of it being an issue. On a Reddit thread to discuss the issue, International Community Manager Scarper said, "We are aware of the shortfalls and clear disadvantage. The intent of the change was simply to make a more fair reward for player assists and kills via crashes. To earn a kill when a target crashes, and for those who have made a greater contribution to reducing the flight characteristics of the target and not just spray shots as the target was crashing. It is not working as intended and is bugged. It will be reworked and fixed as soon as the dev team returns from hibernation." Do snails hibernate? Well, learn something new every day, I guess. Anyways, that's all the news for this week. Yes, literally, that's it. Every outlet that I look for news has been rather quiet, is because the Gaijin devs are sleeping, or whatever the Russians do during winter. So if you have any comments or concerns, hit me up down below on my Discord. If you liked the video, hit the like button. If you didn't like the video, don't hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit that subscribe button. I make news videos every weekend, and I make random videos throughout the week, and I like to stream on Friday, so hit that subscribe button and hit the bell icon to be notified anytime I upload anything. Thanks for watching, and I hope you have a great day.